ABBYY FlexiCapture, processing server, and processing stations. We'll talk about the processing server monitor, connecting the processing server and the processing stations, starting the processing stations, and drilling down and looking closely at the tasks that are being processed by the processing station. Here we see that the processing server is working closely with the application server. So right here, the application server receives files and stores the files in a file storage location, and then will invoke the processing server. Let's say a new batch is scanned. That's a batch that needs to be recognized. So the application server will store it and then tell the processing server there's work to do. The processing server will then find an available processing station or load balance, will queue up one of the processing stations to do that actual work. Notice that there's multiple processing stations here and that they can be horizontally or vertically scaled. So if we need to add more processing stations, we can do that, or we can keep the same amount of processing stations and add more cores. The processing server is effectively a load balancer. It distributes tasks among the processing stations. So if I had maybe two processing stations with four cores, with two cores each, I could replace that with a single processing station with four cores. But it makes more sense to have two processing stations with two cores so that load balancing and redundancy is there. Processing stations are used for recognition, ingestion, and export primarily. And those are CPU intensive duties. So it's a very good idea to have dedicated processing stations. Most people virtualize their processing stations. The processing server monitor comes with a GUI that's very convenient for keeping your eye on what's going on in your system. So we can check right here, the processing server is turned on and we have one active processing station. Now, if you're in a scenario where, let's say you're pre-production and your system was working fine, say Monday evening, you put in documents into a hot folder and the documents are processed. But then on Tuesday morning you return and you put images in the hot folder and they're just sitting there. As your expertise in FlexiCapture Distributed grows, you could get in and at a granular level diagnose what the problem is. But before you're at that stage, a quicker and easier way to reboot your system without really restarting any servers is to come here, right-click, and restart your processing server. You have that option when you right-click. The submenu allows you to do that. And that will restart your processing stations as well. So they'll go yellow and then they'll turn back on green. And at that point, I would check my hot folder and see if everything got picked up and was running again. The processing server is responsible for redirecting licenses to the scan station and the data verification station, the verification station. So the processing server must be running for a workstation to get a license. Just to recap, the processing server is used to distribute tasks. It's a load balancer. Tasks are completed automatically. There's no operator attention required, no operator involvement. The three big tasks that the processing station achieves are recognition, ingestion, and export. And the processing server monitor allows you to keep an eye on what's going on, and it allows you to restart the processing server and or the processing stations. You can also configure the processing stations from that GUI. They're typically designed to run all three of these tasks, but you can give them more of a granular set of duties. You could have one processing station just do one task, one of these three tasks. Most people leave all three on by default, so that's kind of up to you. And last, I'll just repeat that processing stations can be horizontally or vertically scaled.